Really? I don't know where my wallet is.
I would not have been stupid enough to leave it on the table.
Would I?
Bit of a late start.
I need to get some work done for my actual job. There's two things I need to do first. After I'm done eating my nutritious breakfast.
Nom 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 nom.
Okay. This video is tough because I don't really have a routine.
But long story short, one of the best things you can do to fix your sleep schedule is to go for walks in the sunlight first thing in the morning. Anyway.
And then I kind of want to do a little bit of a deep dive sharing how I got here because this has been about a year in the making. I'm super, super grateful to be 21 and have as much free time as I have and location independence. Yeah, be able to like live a cool life. My story's kind of unique. I got lucky at a lot of places, to be honest. But I think there's some lessons to be learned. To writing, and then to actual work, and then to that. Hello, hello. Yo.
Hey, Jordan.
Yo, what's up? I'm 21 years old. I work at a tech startup, and right now I'm in Lisbon, Portugal. The first introduction for me to this sort of lifestyle was when I was still in university. I read this book called The 4-Hour Workweek by Tim Ferriss. The old concept is you'd make a ton of money, retire, and then go travel and go live life and live luxuriously. But Tim Ferriss's idea was you kind of can build in these mini retirements into your actual life. You can go live somewhere cheap, like Thailand, Bali, even Portugal, and you can do all this traveling while you're still living your normal life if you position yourself well. The main point of all this, yeah, you don't need to be super rich to travel the world anymore, but you do need like a base level of security, which is why I think building up skills that can be valuable on the internet is so important if that's something you care about. Video editing, design, UI and UX design is super profitable. Even graphic design, coding, obviously, copywriting. Like, there's probably list videos on how to make money on the internet. But like, if you can really lock in and find a skill like that, that you can obsess over and get good at, then there's like a whole world out there and you don't need universities to do that. Also, you don't need to be super party to travel. Like, I enjoy being by myself and working and grinding and building my career, and I'm still doing the digital nomad thing. And yeah, those are the main points I wanted to cover. So,
really? I don't know where my wallet is.
I had it this morning when I went for my walk. So I remember trying to use it.
It's a tripod.
But then what? But then what? I would not have been stupid enough to leave it on the table.
Would I?
Turns. Hard to tell if the wallet is there. Here, it's leaning up on my wallet and the phone. Fully looks like I just picked up the phone.
Am I stupid?
Am I actually? No.
Oh, me. Okay. God damn it. What the fuck is it in the laundry?
You know the funny thing is, right? So I stayed in a hotel my first night here, and then I came to the Airbnb, and I think I left a little bag full of SD cards. I was thinking of I should go to the hotel and pick them up. But I was thinking that would be a good underlying narrative. The vlog. But real life just hit me. My own stupidity just hit me instead. So, oh my gosh, I should go get dinner.
I think this is a fucking project. And that building says Economica on it. It means it's either a school of economics or something like economic development. I don't know how to read the rest of it. It's not the sketchiest thing in the world though.
Being quiet because I don't want to wake up anyone else in the apartment. It's 3. I've just been video editing since I got back. The full video, me breaking down my dropout to nomad story, will be released tomorrow. But if you're watching this after that, then it's right here. Remember when vloggers did that like 10 years ago and thought they were Steven Spielberg?